Hello, Namaste, and welcome to What's in the News this month. In the platform segment, we'll bring you all the latest updates from the Salesforce platform. We'll start with the latest ideas that got into the Salesforce roadmap. We'll then check what are the latest features in Spring 21 release, and we'll also cover the updates from the Salesforce CLI and the Lightning Web Components. We'll then see what's coming and what's happening for the Salesforce developers. We'll catch up with the events, and then we'll also check the awesome work being done by our trailblazers in the community focus. Finally, we'll do a quick round of news items. The mobile extensions for Salesforce CLI are now generally available. You can deploy Lightning Web Components to a test app and preview it locally. If you haven't tried the mobile emulators yet, or if you are one like me looking for an easy to understand but short video tutorials, then you are covered. Check this playlist on Salesforce Developers YouTube channel. Salesforce Developers has published a playlist for Salesforce mobile tools. It has a video on how to install and set up a Salesforce mobile app emulator for Android. It also has a video on how to set up the simulator for the iOS. Finally, it has a video on how to use this emulator and simulator to build, preview, and debug Lightning Web Components. It also shows how to link the Chrome and Safari developer tools. A new version of the mobile SDK 9.0 is released. It is focused on developer and end-user productivity. If you have missed this announcement, then check this blog. This blog covers the release highlights in detail, and you can also check what is new for iOS, Android, or React app developers. The Spring 21 release is almost there. Hope you already checked the release readiness live of Spring 21. If not, then the video is now available on demand. Let's now check some of the coolest features from the Spring 21 release. Did you try Spring 21 yet? If so, you would have noticed this trailhead icon here. Yes, it's a new edition and it's called the Guidance Center. You can assign trailhead modules to the users so that they can quickly ramp up by learning through those modules. Not just that, even the in-app guidance has become powerful with Spring 21 bundled with more features. Source tracking is now generally available in all developer and developer pro sandboxes. This feature keeps your metadata changes synchronized between your local workspace and your org. You can pull or push the change metadata using four source commands. You can now try Sockle Builder Beta on VS Code. It is the quickest way to write the Sockle queries. You can build a query with clicks and then see the results next to your query. We are continuously adding features to it. And what is latest is that you can toggle between the editor and builder with a click of an icon. The code completion is also improved, and you can start it from the command palette. New Sockle Fields function is generally available. It's a new simple way to explore the data in your Salesforce objects. It enables you to designate a predefined grouping of columns that will be automatically returned in the result set of records. Not just that, you can also select all the fields at once with this function, which is pretty much similar to get star in SQL. OpenAPI 3.0 specification for REST API is now in the pilot. A specification describes what an API can do, how to consume it, parameters, authentication methods that it accepts, and returns a result in a human or machine readable format. Check this blog to learn more about it. Also, don't forget to watch this DreamTX session for a demo. Do you use the component library in the playground for quick prototyping of your Lightning Web Components? Then there's a bad news for you. And also, there is a good news. Let's first check what is bad news. The component library will not be available in Playground from March 1st. Okay, then what's the good news? You can use a third-party solution such as webcomponents.dev. Webcomponents.dev lets you build the components using various frameworks. You can build the component, push the code, publish the package, and deploy it to a static website to demo it. you can build lighting web components using it. It has an LWC playground and demos of 70 base components. You can check the examples of lighting base components or create your own custom component using the playground. Let's now look into some of the event news. You can now register for Salesforce Live, Australia and New Zealand event. It is starting on 24th March. It has 9 episodes of 4 hours each, spanning 6 weeks, and each episode covers sales, financial services, etc. It's now time for the community focus. In this episode, let's see how our awesome trailblazers are selflessly helping other trailblazers to skill up. Apex House needs no introduction. It's a program of the community, for the community, and led by the community. Whether you are a beginner starting with the Salesforce platform, intermediate, or advanced developer, you can find free training or session on this website. At the top, you can see a blog, upcoming sessions, previous sessions, etc. Let's hover over free Salesforce training and check what we have for the developers. Here you can see an ordered list of sessions for a student to get started with Apex, tools, testing, integrations, etc. Do you want to get started with the CPQ? It has a collection of 22 sessions to get you started. Now, let's hear from its founder Amit Chaudhary on what was his inspiration for this initiative and its success story.
Hello everyone, my name is Amit Chaudhary. I am the founder of the Salesforce Apex Hour. Salesforce Apex Hour is a space that helps Salesforce experts across the globe to share their expertise with the Salesforce Ohana. I started Salesforce Apex Hour in 2016 and so far we did 300 plus sessions in the Apex Hour with three major training programs that include Salesforce Admin, Salesforce Developer and the Salesforce CPQ. Good news is that lots of person got their first job just because of this program, and more than 8,000 plus students learn the Salesforce and enter into Salesforce ecosystem. All the sessions are recorded and available on Apex Hour YouTube channel. I just want to say big thanks to all our speakers and my co-organizer Jigar Shah and Amit for helping me in this program. We will keep coming with the good content in Apex Hour. Keep watching.
Thank you so much, Amit, Jigar, Amit and all the contributors for whatever you're doing for this community. Let's now quickly check what's the buzz on the Salesforce Developers India Telegram channel these days. Salesforce Developers Telegram channel has launched a new series called Tuesday Trivia, where you get to test your knowledge in a fun way. Did you check the trivia this week? The latest Salesforce Developer Survey is now open. You can help us identify trends and learn more about what all Salesforce developers want. It takes less than 15 minutes. Please share your ideas for the best content through all our developer channels. One of the common asks from the developer community is a platform where developers can interact with each other. A platform where they can ask questions, share ideas, understand the patterns, and learn the industry best practices from each other. This has given us the inspiration to start a voice chat on our favorite Telegram channel, Salesforce Developers India. Here, you can chat with developer advocates and also interact with other developers. This highly interactive voice chat session happened on 12th February, and going forward, it will be conducted every month. Please let us know what time works best for you and also what you expect more out of this session. In short, is a weekly digest with enriched content and events that happen every week. Stay tuned for it every Friday. That's all in the news today. See you in next episode with latest updates. Until then, keep trailblazing.